Well, I've finally done it. I've made the perfect mashed potatoes. Okay, you've got a potato decision to make. Do you want fluffy or do you want creamy? We're going to do creamy, so we're going to go with Yukon Gold potatoes for this. Thank you, Canada. It's probably your greatest contribution to mankind, right behind maple syrup and hockey. We're just doing a little baby recipe here, so I've got a little less than a pound of these potatoes. But you see, I cut into small chunks about that size right there. Now we're going to put those chunks into a bowl. You see my scraper there, my favorite tool in the kitchen. Need to get you one of those. And see those bits that didn't quite make it in? Those are hesitators. All right, this is an important step. You've got to wash the starch off of those potatoes. So put them in a bowl, put water over them, rinse them with your hand. Try to get all that starch off of there. You'll see that the water turns a little cloudy, and then you put it back in the strainer. Repeat this two or three times until the water's clear. This is after three times, the water's pretty clear. That's what you're looking for. You want clear water, however many times you need to wash those potatoes and get them clear. That's what you need to do. That starch is not helping things. Okay, when those potatoes are completely washed, just put just enough water over them that they're covered. That's all you need, because all you're going to do is simmer them, not boil them. Really important, vital step. I don't have any footage of it, but I did add salt here, about 2 tablespoons. And it's so much better than adding salt later. It infuses the entire potato with a nice saltiness, but not too salty, just right. See this type of butter? Get it. Just trust me on this one. It has a little higher fat content than regular butter. It definitely has more flavor than the regular type butter, and it's going to make the creamy potatoes you're going after very creamy and very rich. Trust me on this one. See that right there? That's what you want. You just want a light simmer. You don't want to overcook these in a boil and have them break up into a million pieces. And the reason you want it at a simmer is because you want the inside to be just as done as the outside, and bringing it up slowly to a simmer does that. There's that Irish butter again. You want about 2 teaspoons per pound of potato. You want to put that in a pan, low heat, and liquefy, and that's how you're going to incorporate that into the potatoes. Now we're going to put them back in the pot over low heat. So we're going to steam those even some more to get some more of that water out. The water in the potatoes at this point is not your friend either. And we want to get that water out so we can replace it with the good stuff. Butter and heavy cream. Hey, if you like this content or it helps you in any way, please push like and subscribe. That really helps me out. And this is a potato ricer. It's like a garlic press, but for potatoes. And yes, if you really want to make creamy, awesome potatoes, get away from that potato masher. Get one of these. It's 15 bucks. You'll thank me. You saw me put white pepper there. It is the only spice I'm going to put in this. Next goes the melted butter. Notice I'm not putting the cream in at this point. Very important. Now notice as I just fold the butter in here, I don't want to overwork those potatoes, okay? I don't want to disrupt the cell structure any more than I have to. And I add just a little bit of homemade chicken stock. This is a secret ingredient. You want to heat up that cream before adding it to the potatoes. Now, you can add an herb or some garlic or some other kind of spice, but I really don't think you need to with this recipe. Part of the greatness of this is its simplicity and its richness. I'm doing a pseudo fold again of the cream into the potatoes. Add some more cream. Continue to pseudo fold that in until it's fully incorporated. And right about now, you see the consistency you're going to want. It I know at this point it looks a lot soupier than you think is right, but it will stiffen up a little bit. It's what you want. We've got to add a little green, so let's garnish this with a little chive. Okay, so we're 5.5 minutes into this, and when I was researching for this video, I found a lot of interesting things out about potatoes and their history, like they're indigenous to Western South America, then the conquistadors took them to Europe, and then Europe to Africa, and then Africa to Asia, and then finally to North America. In the United States, we were the last big country to get them, and it was after the Civil War. Amazing. Now, while they were in Europe in the early days, like the late 1500s, 1600s, potatoes were actually outlawed because people thought they caused leprosy and syphilis. Can you imagine the guy trying to explain to his wife why she got syphilis from? Say, honey, I promise you I was not cheating on you. All I had was some mashed potatoes. And there's the final product. It's beautiful, it's rich, it's luxurious, and it's absolutely delicious. If you make this for the holidays, you're gonna get a lot of compliments on it, but don't be like PJ and eat this entire thing in one setting. And yeah, it seems a little rich when you do that. But as long as you moderate yourself, you should be fine, and you'll be glad you've done this. Until next time, take care.